हाय डॉक्टर प्रवीण साहवे फ्रॉम अभ्युदय पाईल्स लेजर हॉस्पिटल रामेश्वरी स्क्वेअर नागपूर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ म्युकोर मायकोसिस दॅट इज कॉल्ड झायगो मायकोसिस अँड विच इज व्हेरी कॉमन आफ्टर पोस्ट कोविड इन्फेक्शन. म्युकोर मायकोसिस इज अ फंगल इन्फेक्शन अँड इट इज कॉज्ड बाय झायगो मायसिस अँड सिमटम्स इन्क्लूड फीवर, हेडेक, कफिंग, शॉर्टनेस ऑफ ब्रेथ, ॲबडॉमिनल पेन, ब्लडी वॉमिट and possibly altered mental status. Zygomycosis, that is mucormycosis, is a serious and potentially deadly fungal infection that is infrequently diagnosed. What happened? The risk factors include poorly controlled debilitating disease, that is diabetes, or those patients who are immunosuppression, and trauma, usually serious injuries. And these patients are most prone for this infection. The symptoms and signs appear usually in the body area affected and may occur as follows, like fever, headache, reddish and swollen eye, skin or nose and sinuses, and dark scabbing in nose by eyes, visual problems, eye swelling, facial pain, coughing sometimes with bloody or dark fluid production, and shortness of breath, diffuse abdominal pain, bloody and sometimes dark vomiting, and abdominal distension, flank pain, and ulcer with a dark center and sharply defined edges. Sometimes in last stages there is a mental status changes also in mucormycosis. So the preliminary diagnosis is made by the patient history, physical examination, patient's risk factors, and after that the definitive diagnosis is done. Most of the patients require surgical debridement of the infected tissue, antifungal drugs, mainly amphotericin B, and good control of treatment of underlying medical problems such as diabetes. And the complications of the mucormycosis is blindness, organ dysfunction, loss of body tissue due to infection and debridement, and suddenly death also. The prognosis of the mucormycosis infection ranges from fair to poor. There is about 50% death rate, which rises to about 85% for renocerebral and GI infections. So prevention of the mucormycosis centers are avoidance of or control of the risk factors, but it should not be prevented in all infections, and there is no vaccine for the mucormycosis. So we should always take precautions in this present scenario of COVID. Post-COVID infection of mucormycosis is very common in nowadays, and so all patients of the COVID should be given antifungal treatment for preventive point of view for mucormycosis. So what are the risk factors for the mucormycosis? If we see, risk factor for the mucormycosis include debilitating disease progress, especially disease that can yield compromised blood flow to the tissue. And the classical example in this patient with uncontrolled diabetes and foot ulcers, where debris can reach to the compromised tissue. Patient with burns, malignancies, immunocompromised patients, and patients with splenectomy, and the people with wound, with severe usually, have contaminated with the soil or environmental water, are higher risk to get the mucormycosis. Nowadays, the patients of the COVID on oxygenation, when they are on oxygen supply, the water used in the oxygen container should be sterile water, not from the tap water. So it can prevent some sort of infection there also. So the symptoms of the mucormycosis are depending on the types. If we see the renocerebral mucormycosis, the symptoms are fever, headache, reddish and swollen skin or nose, sinuses, and dark scabbing in the nose of eyes, visual problems, eye swelling and facial pain. In pulmonary mucormycosis, there is fever, coughing, sometimes with bloody and dark fluid production and shortness of breath. And in GI mucormycosis, there is a diffuse abdominal pain, bloody and sometimes dark vomiting and abdominal distension. In renal mucormycosis, there is a fever, flank pain, And in cutaneous mucormycosis, initially there is a reddish swelling initially to the skin of the trauma and becomes ulcer and dark center and sharply defined edges. And in disseminated mucormycosis, there is all above symptoms including headache and spread of the disease to the other organs, and mental status is changed. So all these are the symptoms according to the types. So how it is diagnosed? It is diagnosed based on the patient's history, physical examinations, and risk factor for the fungal infection. Although tests like CT and MRI help to define the extent of the infection to the specific organ. So all these tests are done, and for treatment point of view, antifungal treatments, antifungal medications, that is amphotericin B, initially intravenous, is usually choice of drug. And in addition, posaconazole or isavuconazole may treat the mucormycosis. Control of the diabetes, and the patient normally on steroids are undergoing treatment with diphragmine, that is desperol, used to remove the excess of iron in the body, are likely to have these medications stopped because they can increase the survival of the fungi in the body. So always should take precautions that this drug should not be given. And patients are need of additional surgeries like debridement and antifungal therapy also. So all this is about the mucormycosis. There are serious complications of the disease, that is blindness, meningitis, brain abscess, osteomyelitis, pulmonary hemorrhages, gastrointestinal hemorrhages, and cavitary lesions in the organ of the secondary bacterial infection, that is sepsis and death also. So this is all about the mucormycosis. So we have to prevent this mucormycosis, because avoiding the predisposing factors or the disasters, hurricanes, and taking safety measures in possible, it is the best way. Because if warming of tsunami, tornado, or earthquake are probably the best ways to avoid the mucormycosis. Patients with debilitating disease can increase the symptoms. So good control for the diabetes also. And some clinicians suggest that the patient is exposed to the circumstances that are favorable for the mucormycosis to develop. If they are taking prednisone or diphragmine, so they should cease these medications and consult your doctor before seizing these medications. So all this is about the mucormycosis. And in Ayurveda, there are good results in early cases if you treat the patients. Because in Ayurveda, Raktach Krumi Varnan is there. So, Nasahi Shirso Dwaram. The nose is entrance for the brain. So, the medications like Nasya therapy, some immunomodulator medications, that our own research product, that is Immunopil capsule, if you want to prevent this disease. There is a combination of the herbal drugs, which are antifungal also. The Nimba Patra, Haridra, and one antiviral drug, that is Bhumi Amalaki, and another immunomodulator drugs which is present in Immunopil capsule, can further prevent the disease also. So before taking medications, consult your doctor and get prevented with the disease. Thank you very much. So stay safe and use Ayurveda for prevention.